Good morning, everyone. It's another beautiful day today.
It sure is, Judy. We're reporting to you from sunny New York City with today's scoop.
The zoo's baby first gazelle was born at 5 a.m. this morning. His name is Charlie, and you can visit our website and watch this little guy take his first steps.
I've probably seen it 25 times today. I love it when he falls on his face. We had a whopping 4 inches of snowfall last weekend. But you can expect empty skies and clear roads to finish all your Christmas shopping.
That's exactly right, everyone. We only have 3 days until Christmas. Luckily for all the procrastinators out there, every major department store will now stay open through the night for your convenience. The doors will close by 9 p.m. on the 24th for the holiday. Those stores are also holding sizable sales. You can get more details on our homepage.
Thank you, Judy. As always, we hope you have a cheerful day.
Absolutely. This is Judy and Tom signing off.
Order! I'd like to call this meeting to order. As some of you have heard, there's a rumor going around that a new superhero is coming to town.
That's all your lines.
Oh, they say that he is coming to save the world and that he receives his powers from God.
What do you mean? We saved the earth. We have been here for years. What does this guy think he's doing?
Do we even know who this guy or woman is? Doesn't he know that's our job?
I heard this God means real business. He says he loves the world so much, he will give us his son.
This new superhero is here to save the world from sin.
Who is this sin? I don't know this evil villain. Catwoman, is he one of your arch nemeses?
No, I don't know him, but I know that I could take him down and probably better than this new guy.
Okay, let's calm down. We don't know if this guy is here to help us as well as the rest of the world.
Well, we don't need any help. Did you see me clutch the bad guy last week and save a bus full of kids with one hand? Do we even know when this new guy is supposed to show up?
I've heard as early as Christmas Day.
No way! Christmas is only a few days away.
Yes, Hulk, just a few days. I think your neck muscles are cutting off the circulation to your brain.
We have to act fast. We have to find this guy and his enemies. Oh no, we have so much to do.
Well then, we better start tracking this big guy down.
Reporting to you live from New York City, folks.
That's right, Judy. And sadly, it won't be good news. During the holiday season, crime typically drops into lower numbers. Experts believe it's due to the Christmas spirit. This year, however, crime is at an all-time high.
Many citizens feel the superheroes are to blame. Twitter is blowing up with worried New Yorkers. The heroes haven't been seen anywhere in the city for 2 days. We checked with our international sources earlier, and they haven't seen them either. I think it's safe to say that they are indeed missing.
It looks like a dark holiday for everyone. Candlelight vigils will be held tonight at several local churches. You can find their locations on our webpage. Continuing with tonight's headlines, every hotel in town is completely booked. We've been told this is a first for New York.
The police encourage everyone, especially out-of-towners, to stay inside after sunset for your safety. They also encourage traveling in groups and to avoid walking as much as possible. I sincerely hope you were done with all your Christmas shopping.
This is Tom and Judy signing off from the Evening Report. Good luck.
Out. Can't we just book a room somewhere? I am so tired of all this walking.
Only a little bit farther, love. I'm sorry that Aubrey Holiday Inn was full, but I didn't know we'd be traveling this late into the holiday season.
Don't get huffy at me. I didn't ask to flee my home or to become the mother of God's son.
Yes, dear, I know. How did that happen again? You were so frightened when you came to me.
Well, an angel from God came to me. He told me God chose me to bear a son, and I am to call him Jesus. I was really scared. But then the angel said not to be frightened, because this means that God will always be with me. I'm still nervous and unsure about this whole thing. What if I'm not going to be a good mother to God's son? I mean...
Mary, stop worrying and breathe. God chose you for a reason, and he chose me as your husband for a reason. Or at least, that's what I keep telling myself.
Man, this superhero really knows how to hide himself. Maybe he's in a disguise.
I feel like I have to turn over everything.
Hulk, put that down. Do you really think the man who saves the world would be hiding under there?
Yes.
I'm tired of looking. Maybe he has a weakness like tuna or catnip or those little squeaky mice or those lights that you can, like, never catch.
Maybe they heard something about him. Excuse me, do you know about a new superhero?
A new superhero? No. Joseph, have you?
No way, are you really Superman? Oh my goodness, and Wonder Woman and the Hulk? And
oh, get a hold of yourself. No, we haven't. Do you know of a place where we could stay? All the inns are full.
I know a man down the road who has a nice stable. You can ask him if he knows of a place.
Wow, you guys are all my heroes. You save the world like every day and you're here right now.
Yes, we know. We're pretty powerful.
Oh, wow, you're pregnant.
Yes, I'm due any day now. It may even be tonight.
Oh, there's nothing cuter than a baby.
I hope we run into you again. I would love to hold your baby.
Me too. I love to rock babies to sleep.
Hold on. And you've never crushed one?
Yeah, that would be nice. I'm sure I need all the help I can get.
You would come see us again? Oh, wow.
Do you know if it's a boy or a girl? What are you going to name it? How big will it be?
It's a boy, and his name will be Jesus. Well, my feet are getting sore. I think we will give that man with the stable a try. Good luck with your search for this new superhero.
Congratulations on the baby.
Good luck.
Good luck.
So excited.
This job is so lame.
Hey, I wouldn't complain. It's paying for that data for that fancy phone.
Ha ha ha. Seriously, this job is so boring. Nothing exciting ever happens. All my friends work at Starbucks to get free coffee. And what do I get? I get a shovel sheep poop.
Oh, come on. It isn't that bad. It's a nice night. Just look at the sky full of stars and appreciate the wonder that God created.
Ugh, you're one of those God people?
Well, yeah, I guess I am. I've heard that God is sending his son to save us from our sin.
Mm-hmm. You got that right. Who is that?
And where are you?
We're right here. Don't freak out. We're angels from God. We bring in good news.
Sheesh, lay off the glare. Miley Cyrus called it. She wants her outfit back.
Ha ha. Miley Cyrus wishes she had these clothes.
We're here to tell you that Jesus, the Son of God, was born tonight.
So rejoice, for the Savior of the universe is born.
Oh my goodness, are you serious? How exciting. Where is he? Can I go see him?
Yes, please do. Follow the star, and you will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes.
Why is this baby such a big deal? What and in what are swaddling clothes?
God sent his son Jesus so that we could be forgiven of our sins.
When we do bad things or make bad choices, we're sinning against God.
When we sin, we are moving away from God.
But God loves us so much that he is willing to send his son to us that even when we do sin, we are forgiven.
It's called grace.
Wow, God's love is amazing.
I still don't get how sinning a baby is going to help, though. How is he going to stop me from sinning?
God, Jesus is coming to help us build a relationship with God.
He will be a way for us to see God and know that he loves us.
So no matter how far...
Do you mind? So no matter how far we move away from God, Jesus will be there to remind us that God will never give up on us.
But seriously, get a move on to the stables.
Excuse me, fine Shepherds, have you heard anything about a new superhero that is coming to save the Earth?
We have been looking for him all day and we're exhausted.
We're scared he is going to take our jobs.
Whoa, first angels, now superheroes. Maybe this job isn't so lame after all.
I don't know anything about the new superhero, but we heard that God's son was born tonight.
Wait, did you say God's son? That's our guy.
We haven't been searching for a baby. How could a baby save the world? It can't even walk.
I don't really get it either, but let's go see. I just want to see the super baby God thing. Hey, did we lose Batman? Oh, never mind.
Superheroes have been missing. We have had a few break-ins ourselves.
Brittany is informing me that every road in the city is backed up with traffic. If you're planning to make a run for it, you may not get very far.
We are also getting reports of aliens being spotted on the outskirts of town. Most social media feeds say they saw a pair of strange glowing creatures at a sheep farm.
Wait, what? Now there's a sheep farm in the middle of downtown New York City?
Please do not try making contact with these creatures. The last thing this city needs is washed out alien selfies.
I mean, not to mention the potential danger factor. As you might have guessed, all the stores are now closed. Christmas services have been canceled everywhere, and Santas are abandoning their posts.
What just happened?
Oh my gosh! They're here! Run for it!
Ah! Hello? Is anybody up here? This is Brittany. Looks like the top floor is clear. Thank you.
isn't he wonderful?
I never knew a baby could be this perfect. God has given us such a blessing.
Shh. All right, you superheroes, put your hands up. Nobody is taking my job.
Yeah, what he said!
Shh. Shh. It's a sleeping baby!
Well, yeah, but that baby is going to steal our jobs. And he is so cute.
Thank you. I didn't expect to see you guys again so soon. What is this about my son taking your jobs?
Well, we heard Jesus is a new superhero coming to town and that he is going to save the whole world from sin.
So we thought that no one would need us anymore, but this is just a baby, so what do we have to worry about?
Shh. Oh my gosh!
There he is!
So are they wrong? Is Jesus just a baby?
Well, right now he is, but God has great plans in store for him. He will grow up and save us from our sin.
We heard all about that. An angel came to us and told us not to be afraid since Jesus was born. He will bring us grace.
You know, you're starting to sound like one of those church people.
Well, maybe I could come to church with you sometime.
You know, you're... Yeah, I think I know just the place to take you.
Hold on. So Jesus isn't taking my job. I still get to go out and save people?
Of course you can still go save people. God sent his son so that we could be saved from ourselves.
Jesus reminds us of God's love and how we can share it with others. Now when you save people, you can tell them about Jesus' power and God's unending love for us.
Wow, I think I could do that. Stop right there, mister. I will save you innocent citizens, but Jesus will save you with God's love. I like it.
Actually, we really don't need to be saved from anything right now.
We just wanted to see the baby and leave these gifts.
Shh. How did you know we were here?
We saw the star. We knew that it marked the location of a special king. You see, we all believe in God. We were taught that one day a star would mark his son's coming.
As astrologers, we noticed this new star right away. We left as soon as we saw it.
Well, we had to, otherwise the stores would be closed and we'd have nothing to give him.
But it's not that. Wait, why would the stores close so early?
Since you superheroes went missing, crime in the city is at an all-time high.
Yeah, it was all over the news.
It's pretty bad out there. People think that Christmas is ruined this year.
Oh man, we didn't think about how long we'd be looking for baby Jesus.
We need to get back right now, and fast.
She's right. We need to clean up the city so that Christmas isn't wrecked.
Let's get a move on then.
I'm so glad you came to see us and that you'll spread God's love. Good luck.
Congratulations.
Shh.
Boy, they sure have their work cut out for them.
Wow, that's very kind. That's a strange smell.
Oh, it's probably the mirth. Don't worry, the bread isn't weird, just gluten and pesticides free. Merry Christmas.
Here you go.
That's a year's worth of frankincense. I have more than enough since I coupon.
Wow, thank you.
If you get on Pinterest, you'll find tons of use for it. Enjoy.
You're going to want to use both hands for this.
Wow, is that real gold?
Wouldn't a check have been easier?
I don't trust banks, old mailmans, or the government in general. I would bury that if I were you, just saying.
Thanks, have a nice night.
Shh.
Hey, it's my baby.
I am not afraid anymore. I trust God and His plan. Just look how everything worked out tonight.
I feel more at peace, too. God's love really is vast.
It's another glorious morning in New York City. We are reporting to you live on Christmas Day. It's 10 a.m. and a miracle. We are still here for many locals. It was crazy in the hours leading up to this morning due to our hero's vanishing act.
That's right, Tom. But just in the nick of time, they swooped in and saved the entire city. The creatures feared to be aliens were seen fighting by the hero's side. No one can determine who they really were or where they disappeared to.
Stories are popping up that the heroes are and aliens are telling us of a new super being. This hero has a great power that can save us all, even from ourselves. To learn more about this, check Superman's Twitter.
There are hundreds more wild stories waiting to be seen on the internet. One in particular, however, has gone viral and is sweeping the nation off its feet. A young woman gave birth to her first child in a barn of all places.
Millions of people are reading her story. Many have commented on her bravery and strength, but she says it wasn't all her. She says she couldn't have done it without God.
Perhaps this new super being we need to be looking out for. We hope you're all enjoying a peaceful Christmas with family and friends at home.
We sure do. This is Tom and Judy signing off. Have a holly jolly day.
Merry Christmas.
It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, Oh, by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, yes sir, once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh, by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
That was pretty cool. Yeah, stay up here. Stay up here. I asked you as we started this to pinpoint some kids that you would be willing to connect with in 2017. We want to give living hope to all generations. And as much as they have given us entertainment and the power of the Christmas message, we want to give them living hope for the next generation. And so, you see them behind me. You've picked out one or two. Before you leave, come up to one of them. Say, give me your name again. The names are actually in the bulletin. And say, I will pray for you because there is great hope. And I love you in the name of Jesus. Living hope for all generations. If you're visiting today, we encourage you to come back. Come back Christmas Eve. And weirdly, we have services every Sunday all through next year. And you can come to any one of them. Come early. You get breakfast about 9:30 and then service at 10:30. We hope that God will bless you and give you a rich holiday season. So may the Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face to shine upon you, be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace, but don't leave yet, because I forgot something. Sarah.
Thank you.
This is likely, well, it's actually one of Sarah's last public events with our church. Tim and Sarah are moving.
We're moving to Boston.
Congratulations. Good job.
Thank you.
So, thank you. You guys are dismissed. Thank you.